best known for his unconventional acting roles.
Film business happens when people get together, physically get together in groups. Only then the work happens. Yeah. So when you can't do that, there is no work going to happen. You can't be shooting a film sitting by yourself at home.
He will be next seen in Amazon Prime series opposite Shruti Haasan.
You can watch series at home and you can't watch films at home. Because you want to have that kind of a magnanimous experience, so to say, of the cinema to go into a theatre and be in a surreal world.
Newsix India A-List proudly recognizes Arjun Bajwa for excellence in entertainment.
Hello and welcome. I'm Uday Pratap Singh. You're joining us on this interview as part of our Newsix A-List series. We're in conversation today with well-known actor Arjun Bajwa. Arjun, welcome to Newsix. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much. My pleasure.
Well, let me start out by just talking about this very unprecedented time. As I was just telling you earlier, we last spoke in the first lockdown 1.0 last year, and now lockdown 2.0 this year, Arjun. How did you deal with it? How did you stay sane in these very tough times? How were the last few months for you?
I think last year we were a little bit new to the whole scenario, so we did not really know what to do. And even though there was a fear factor always, it was a sword was hanging on your head that you were not aware of what the consequences of this kind of a situation would be. Yeah. Still, we were a little more optimistic. This time when it happened, it instilled much more fear because you knew what it could do. Mm-hmm. And considering that the second wave was such a shocking, sudden wave, and it was a complete chaos situation. Within a few days, I would say, not even weeks or months, it just spread like wildfire. So this time it was more scary because I very clearly remember that every 5 minutes, you would hear an ambulance going, which was not the case last year because everybody was locked in completely. True. And the infection rate was not spreading so fast. And this year was a pretty scary situation because all you could see, all you could hear all around was that there is, coronavirus deaths happening, and somebody or the other that you knew was down with it.
Yeah.
People lost their lives. I have lost a lot of really close friends during this time. And yeah. So I guess all you can do is hope for the better. Take care of yourself. Keep a positive attitude. It's very easy to say keep a positive attitude. Yeah. I know when it comes down to the situation, the brass tacks, I mean, it doesn't obviously, we are all human beings. Yeah. We are not machines that will, we're attuned to a certain way of things. Yeah. So it's very easy to say it, but what choice do we have? What's the other choice do we have? You know, instead of just being positive about it and thinking that, okay, fine, let's do what we can in our hands at the moment.
Work-wise for you as well, has it been difficult? Because I think a shoot of yours also got stalled because of this. And plus for actors, it's not easy to work from home. Like certain other professions, have started working from home. You can't do that in the film industry, can you?
Yes, absolutely. Because, it's very easy to say that tumhari shoot rukni hogi yaar. What difference does it make? When is the shoot starting? So sometimes for people, it becomes entertainment, topic of entertainment. So how are you shooting? How many people are shooting? They don't understand that it's a profession. Our profession is a tough profession because, like you also said, you can't work from home. You can't sit on a desk. Film business happens when people get together, physically get together in groups. Only then the work happens.
Yeah.
So when you can't do that, there is no work going to happen. You can't be shooting a film sitting by yourself at home, on a camera and putting it across. So it was difficult, no doubt. We are part of the same ecosystem, same society, and then everybody has to follow the same norms and same things. And everyone suffered, and so did our workforce. So yes, I was shooting for a series, and we just kind of, at the fag end of the shoot, and there's only about a week, 10 days of work, which was left around the 15th of April.
Yeah.
And then the lockdown happened, and we were in fact assuming that maybe another week, 10 days when lockdown is lifted, will finish up. And everybody had their own skeds according to the timelines.
Yeah.
But it's been 2 months and we haven't been able to start. And now it seems that things are getting back to normal and we should resume soon.
Great.
So yeah, everyone suffered.
I think that's a project you're doing with Shruti Haasan. Is that correct? Are you looking forward to that?
That's right. That's a series for Amazon. Correct.
Okay. Is it interesting? Is the role interesting? The genre? So I know you can't tell us too much, but...
Well, if it wasn't interesting, why would I be doing it?
Something different for you, or?
It's different in terms of the story. The story is pretty interesting. It's based on a book called Bestseller She Wrote by Ravi Subramaniam. So that's a known fact. And it's a thriller, it's a drama. So, you know, a lot of twists and turns.
Okay.
It's quite entertaining in every way.
Okay. You're just talking now, of course, about your previous projects. You know, a lot of people have been rewatching it, I'm sure. I'm sure you're getting, so much new feedback than it didn't when the first project released. And here I'm talking particularly, of course, about Kabir Singh, which people are watching a lot these days on OTT, and also A State of Siege, a series of yours, which really had a lot of appreciation then, but has been rewatched by a lot of people even now, this time around.
I hope it's being rewatched and it's being watched over and over again multiple times, because State of Siege was a very ambitious project for us, not only in terms of the way it was a subject, it was based on the 2008 Mumbai attacks. Yeah. And we were trying to give an ode to the NSG, to the Black Hat Commandos, who were very instrumental in flushing out the terrorists at that time. Nobody's really kind of made anything from their point of view. So this was made from their point of view. And of course, very well shot, very well made, with all the possible details you could think of. Again, my first series was also based on a book called Black Tornado, The Three Sieges of Mumbai. But unfortunately, it released on the 20th of March, and from 24th March onwards, everything was locked down. So we couldn't really do much of marketing or publicity. We had like a 5-city tour and everything possible, So why I'm saying this is that it's very important for any project to be marketed, publicized before the release in that way, on that scale, for people to understand and know, okay, fine, this is something that we should be watching. All we could do was probably digital promotion on social media and, news channels and interviews from home. So that did help. But considering the kind of publicity that we should have got, or the marketing that should have been done, times at that time, so to say, didn't really allow us. So I'm very happy that people are watching it. I do get a lot of messages. People have really liked my role in that, which I played over real life hero of the Indian Army, Colonel Sunil Charan, now Colonel Saab is Brigadier. So his role was very much appreciated. His role in the whole operation was obviously very instrumental. And that has been watched over and over again. And of course, I'm very happy that all my films, most of them, touch wood, get so much of repeat value on television, that every time it's playing on TV, I get messages from, everywhere, whether it's Fashion or Rustam or Kabir Singh and a few South films as well. So it's a good thing that you have certain milestones in your filmography that people are aware of and they keep looking forward to watching it.
True. Finally, Arjun, as things are going to be resuming now to this new normal, as you were saying, hopefully your shoot will restart once again. Theatres will also open up. We've just heard, of course, about Bell Bottom, which has announced its release date already in theaters. How are OTT and theaters going to balance out? Do you believe there's going to be an audience for both? Are you going to be doing projects for both simultaneously? How are they going to coexist in this new norm?
See, I'll tell you what, to clarify things between OTT and films, there is no difference as such. It's just a difference of exhibition. Medium of exhibition, so to say. And I wouldn't even call that medium of exhibition, because earlier it used to be films used to have satellite rights, so to say, in the correct language. That used to be the satellite rights used to be. So what did satellite mean? You could play it on television. It would play on television, right? And now similarly, whatever content is made on a platform called OTT, over the top, right? It's played on small screen. People prefer to watch it on small screen. I myself never watch any series, whether it's on any platform, on TV. I watch it on my iPad because I find it convenient. It's more of a personal relationship with that series that you're watching. But for an actor, for all the technicians, there is no difference as such, because the filmmaking process is exactly the same. It's rigorous, it's absolutely the same. The kind of stuff that's being made on for OTT in terms of the series are brilliant subjects. Why those subjects are being made on OTT is because sometimes you need more elaborate or more time to say those stories, like State of Siege 2611 for that matter. There was so much to say about the Taj attack episode or the Mumbai attacks, which happened at a few places. that you could not have compiled it into a 2-hour film and shown it to people. Mm-hmm. You know, it needed that kind of detailing.
Yeah.
But as far as films are concerned, films are exactly the same like OTT in terms of shooting process. The filmmaking process is just the same.
Yeah.
It is just that you can watch series at home and you can't watch series films at home. Because you want to have that kind of a magnanimous experience, so to say, of the cinema to go into a theater and be in a surreal world. But films are also releasing on OTT. So I don't know what to say to it in terms of the mishmash or the intermingling of the both.
But I think the point is, of course, that it's both there to entertain and hopefully...
Yeah, absolutely. I do have a good balance of a few series and a few films lined up in the coming times, now in the coming months. And I will obviously, as an actor for me, it's the same process. So I will be, you know, doing both of them, whether it's certain series which are really interesting ones or whether it's certain films which are really up my alley.
Well, look forward to those when they do come out. Arjun, thank you so much for joining us once again on NewsX Today. All the best.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.